Hey Taurus, so this is going to be your messages for the next couple of days. Universe, what is the energy? Okay, so we have the Moon card with the Two of Cups. So this is telling me you have a secret. So this is telling me you have a secret admirer. Could be a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. Okay. We have the Seven of Swords and the King of Coins. So, yeah, I don't feel like you necessarily. I feel like you know who this is, but you. I feel like it's almost a surprise that this person likes you. I do feel that this person also is, with the Seven of Swords and the Moon card, they're really trying to keep their feelings for you a secret for some reason. Could be another Earth sign you're dealing with. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. But I do feel with the Two of Cups here, someone is either growing strong feelings for you or really has strong feelings for you. I feel like these feelings could be new with the Ace of Wands here. It's almost like someone's realizing that they really like you. Okay. We have the Magician here with the Ten of Wands. Could be a Virgo or a Gemini. But someone is extremely shy to talk to you. Like, I feel like it almost really stresses them out thinking about expressing how they feel to you. And I almost feel with the Magician and the Seven of Swords, they're kind of... I almost sort of feel almost manipulating you into thinking they don't like you, but they really do, just because I feel like they're scared to express how they feel to you. Or this could be somebody, like, especially if some of you guys are already in a relationship and somebody really likes you, I feel like they just don't want you to even think that they do. Clarify the Two of Cups. Getting also, maybe they're under the impression that you'll reject them. Could be a fire sign. We have the Knight of Wands here. I also feel that this could be, this is interesting. I almost feel like this could be a friend or an ex that lives at a distance that still has feelings for you. We have the Two of Wands here, so I do feel that you are in a partnership, but this person's already in a partnership. Maybe this person's in a relationship, and maybe that's why it's so important for them to keep their feelings for you a secret. Here we have the Seven of Swords. Okay, I'm also getting for some of you that if you are in a new connection with someone, new relationship, just talking to someone, whatever it is, I feel like this person could have a relationship that they're keeping you a secret, or vice versa. But I'm kind of feeling somebody's keeping you a secret here, because we have the Two of Cups twice with the Two of Wands. Somebody's in a relationship, whether it's you or the other person, and they're keeping it a secret. Like the Seven of Swords here, they're straight up lying about it. So definitely be aware of that. Especially with the Knight of Wands here, this can be kind of like a player-like energy. I don't always like to look at the Knight of Wands like that, but in this situation, I'm kind of feeling like it is. Okay. Yeah, we have the Magician here coming out twice. Somebody's very manipulative. Clarify the King of Coins. Okay. We have the Four of Pentacles and the Seven of Cups. Yeah, they're keeping real quiet about the fact that they have options. So if this is a new connection you're dealing with and you're just not 100% sure if you can trust this person, I don't feel like you can, because they either have a lot of options or are in a relationship or both. Why is the Ace of Wands here? I do feel like this would be a new person in your life. So if you've been with this person for a while, I don't feel like this reading is necessarily for you, because this feels like a new connection. Clarify the Ace of Wands. Why is the Ace of Wands here? Okay. Yeah. So we have the Hierophant here. This is you guys, the Ace of Cups. I just feel advice here is just to be careful of this person. Because this person does really like you, but they're also in, like, this is a situationship I feel like you may not know about yet, but you will find out about. Why is the Magician here? Okay. Yeah, Three of Pentacles with the Empress, Six of Cups. Yeah, somebody's it. Okay. I feel like there's a lot of messages here. For some of you, if there's a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio, from your past, you've already dated this person that you have rekindled love with. They have someone else. They have options. They have a relationship. They already have that, and they're not telling you about it. So be aware of that. Clarify the Ten of Wands. Why is the Ten of Wands here? Yeah, we don't have many pentacles here. I do feel that a lot of you guys are very... There's a lot going on in your love life, or there will be a lot going on in your love life this week or this month. And I'm noticing there are, like, not very many pentacles here. Let's see. I'm going to pull some advice for you guys, because I feel like the month of August, the second half of August, there's going to be a lot going on in your guys' love life. What is the advice for Taurus? What is the advice for Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? Okay, so you have the Page of Water here. I do feel this as advice is to be open to new love. Because I do feel like this could be this person that's like lying or whatever. Definitely could be somebody like from your past. Okay. Yeah, we have the Six of Swords. So the Six of Swords is a card of moving on and moving forward, especially this water sign. We have the Queen of Cups here. Moving on from this water sign, if this is somebody that was in your life previously, is very important because I feel like, I always feel like there's a whole shit show that is going to be revealed to you that you were unaware of. So, anyway, I hope that this was a good reading for you, Taurus. If you'd like to see me do other stuff other than tarot, my vlog channel link is down below. Enjoy the rest of your day.